Hello everyone. I hope 2021 finds you in good health and spirits, and that you look forward to a positive future with Awesome Max hopes. All right, let's talk about one of the breakout books of the past couple of years, Ikigai, The Japanese Secret to a Long and Happy Life by Hector Garcia and Frances Miralles. Now, Ikigai is a Japanese concept that can be loosely translated to a reason for being. The word refers to having a meaningful direction or a purpose in life. Reading this book makes you think, what makes your life worthwhile according to you? It encourages you to carry out actions that result in satisfaction and a sense of meaning in life, rather than just existing in today's increasingly digital world, surrounded by social media and aggravated by the fear of missing out. This concept is pretty cool. It's Japanese, and to do this book, the authors conducted 100 interviews with natives of Okinawa, which is an island in Japan, to try and understand the longevity secrets of centenarians and super centenarians, that is, people who live to be 100 years old or more. But every good concept has its detractors, and the criticism of this book centers on how the studies that claim longevity in Okinawa cannot be substantiated. Recent data reflects that there is no exceptional extended life expectancy of Okinawan people compared to people living in other parts of Japan or other developed countries around the world. Nevertheless, Ikigai is a concept that will give you something to look forward to, whether it is YouTubing or rapping or writing travel stories or looking forward to a football match of the team that you support or even just eating a nice meal. As a nice parting thought, the authors of this book wish you a long, happy, and purposeful life. It has been translated from the Spanish by Heather Cleary for Penguin Random House, who I will also approach for the second volume of my book, A Life Afloat. The transliteration of Japanese to English is pretty interesting as well, because Japanese as a language has a relatively modern history, and this can be understood by the estimated age of their mythological compendium, like we have Ramayana and Mahabharata. It's called Kojiki, and it dates back to only around 8th century in the Common Era. So you can see how Japanese as a language has still a lot to cover in terms of history. Let me leave the linguistics and the anthropology for the experts, and sum up this viral book in one sentence. Strike a balance between what you love, what you are good at, what you can be paid for, and what the world needs. Here is an even shorter summary of the book. Balance these four things: passion, mission, vocation, and profession. To close out, I will tell you what I thought after reading the book and correlating it with my own experiences. Achieving your ambitions is not easy, but if you use your talents, you can bend so-called luck to your advantage if you incorporate Ikigai into your thinking. So I want to keep this brief, like I said, and to end on a lighter note, to give you something else to look forward to in 2021 after the nightmare of 2020. A music album called Ikigai is coming out by a recently re-emerged technical death metal band called Abiotic. So give that a listen when it comes out, and take it one day at a time. Stay safe and see you all next time. Thanks for watching.